On Wednesday, May 15, Mr. Lawrence Wong officially commenced his tenure as the fourth Prime Minister of Singapore. The swearing-in ceremony was graced by numerous distinguished guests, including his wife, Ms. Loo Tzu-Lui. Ms. Loo Tzu-Lui, an influential figure in her own right, has an impressive background in banking and philanthropy. Her multifaceted career and charitable endeavors have significantly contributed to her standing as an esteemed member of the community. Ms. Loo's professional journey began in the banking sector, where she accumulated 12 years of experience. She was described as an investment manager at Sandalwood Associates in the YMCA of Singapore's 2023 annual report. According to an application proof by Razer Incorporated, of which Sandalwood Associates is a shareholder, Ms. Loo is also recognized as an individual private investor. The document highlights her involvement in various investment opportunities across diverse business sectors. In 2009, she held the position of vice president at Pacific Star, a Singapore-headquartered property investment company renowned for its expertise in prime Asian real estate transactions. During her tenure at Pacific Star, Ms. Loo participated in the Habitat for Humanity Singapore's inaugural Women Build program in Batam. This initiative empowers women to make a tangible impact by constructing homes and communities for those living in poverty. Although her biography page is no longer available on the YMCA website, it detailed her extensive background in finance, including wealth management and corporate finance, which has been instrumental in her current ventures. Ms. Loo now manages a single-family office, SFO, an entity defined by the Monetary Authority of Singapore, MAS, as one that oversees assets for or on behalf of only one family and is wholly owned or controlled by members of that family. In 2020, Singapore was home to approximately 200 SFOs, a testament to the city's growing reputation as a hub for wealth management. In addition to her professional achievements, Ms. Loo has a notable history of service on the YMCA board. She was elected to serve a four-year term starting in 2017 and held the position of Vice President, VP, for the 2021/2022 term. She concluded her tenure on November 1, 2023, and officially retired from the YMCA board, as announced by Mr. Kenneth Tan, the VP of YMCA, on May 14, 2024. During her time on the board, Ms. Loo contributed to several committees, including the International House Committee and YMCA Faces, Financial Assistance and Capability for Employment Scheme. Ms. Loo's philanthropic efforts extend beyond her professional commitments. Over the years, she has made substantial donations to various charitable organizations. Notably, she has donated significant amounts to the YMCA, including at least SGD 5,000 in 2018, SGD 500 in 2019, SGD 10,000 in 2020, SGD 1,000 in 2021, and SGD 10,000 in 2023. Additionally, she contributed between SGD 5,000 and SGD 9,999 to the Singapore Art Museum and was honored in 2024 as a major supporter. Ms. Loo's generosity also extends to social events, such as the Crib Ball in 2018, where she was recognized for her philanthropic efforts. Ms. Loo is Prime Minister Wong's second wife. He was previously married at the age of 28, but the couple divorced after 3 years due to incompatibility. Ms. Loo and PM Wong have no children together. Despite the limited information available about their personal lives on social media, it is known that Ms. Loo played a supportive role during the 2020 circuit breaker period by helping PM Wong cut his hair at home. She has also accompanied him on various state visits and events, including a visit to River Wonders with foreign guests in 2022. The couple's appearances at public events, such as President Tharman Shanmugaram's inauguration, have endeared them to the public, with many admiring Ms. Loo's elegance and style. Ms. Loo's educational background includes a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a specialization in finance from the University of Southern California, which she obtained in 1993. This remains the only publicly known information about her education. With PM Wang now officially sworn in, it is anticipated that Ms. Liu will continue to make appearances at various public events, providing the public with further opportunities to learn about her contributions and endeavors.
2024年5月15日星期三, 黄循才先生正式开始担任新加坡第四任总理。宣誓仪式上有许多著名嘉宾出席, 其中包括他的妻子卢子立女士。 卢子立女士本身就是一个有影响力的人物，她在银行业和慈善事业方面有着令人印象深刻的背景。她多方面的职业生涯和慈善事业显著地提升了她作为社区尊敬成员的地位。卢女士的职业生涯始于银行业，在那里她积累了12年的经验。据新加坡基督教青年会 YMCA 2023年度报告， 他在Sandalwood Associates 担任投资经理。根据雷蛇公司的一份申请证明， Sandalwood Associates 是其股东之一，卢女士还被认为是一名个人私人投资者。文件指出，她参与了多个行业领域的投资机会。 2009年， 她在新加坡总部的房地产投资公司 Pacific Star 担任副总裁， 该公司以其在亚洲主要房地产交易方面的专业知识而闻名。 在Pacific Star任职期间， 卢女士参与了新加坡人人家园 Habitat for Humanity Singapore 在巴淡岛启动的首个女性建设项目。该项目赋予女性通过为贫困家庭建造住房和社区来做出实际贡献的能力。 尽管她的个人简介页面已从 YMCA 网站上移出，但该页面详细介绍了她在财务方面的丰富背景，包括财富管理和企业财务，这对于她后来的事业至关重要。卢女士目前管理着一个单一家族办公室 SFO， 这是新加坡金融管理局 MAS 定义的一个专门为一个家族管理资产，并完全由家族成员拥有或控制的实体。 2020年，新加坡大约有200个 SFO， 这证明了新加坡作为财富管理中心的声誉日益提高。除了她的职业成就外，卢女士在 YMCA 董事会的服务历史也值得注意。 他在2017年当选为4年任期的董事， 并在2021-2022年担任副会长。 他在2023年11月1日结束了任期， 并于2024年5月14日 正式从YMCA董事会退休。 这一消息由YMCA副会长 Kenneth Tan先生宣布。 在他担任董事期间， 卢女士参与了多个委员会， 包括国际住房委员会和 YMCA 财务援助与就业能力计划 YMCA Faces。 卢女士的慈善努力超越了她的职业承诺。多年来，她向各种慈善机构捐赠了大量资金，特别是她向 YMCA 捐赠了大量资金，包括2018年的至少5000新元， 2019年的至少500新元， 2020年的至少10000新元， 2021年的至少1000新元， 以及2023年的至少10000新元。 此外，他还向新加坡艺术博物馆 捐赠了5000至9999新元， 并在2024年被表彰为主要支持者。 卢女士的慷慨还延伸到社交活动， 例如她在2018年的Crib Ball中 因其慈善努力而受到认可。 卢女士是总理黄的第二任妻子，她在28岁时第一次结婚，但因性格不合在3年后离婚。卢女士和黄总理没有孩子。尽管他们的个人生活在社交媒体上信息有限，但已知在2020年段陆琪期间，卢女士曾在家中帮助黄总理理发。她还陪同他出席了各种国家访问和活动， 包括2022年与外国嘉宾一起参观和川生态园。这对夫妇在公共活动中的亮相，如总统尚穆加拉特南的就职典礼，赢得了公众的喜爱。许多人赞赏卢女士的优雅和风格。 卢女士的教育背景包括1993年从南加州大学获得的商业管理学士学位，专业是金融，这是她教育背景的唯一已知信息。随着黄总理正式宣誓就职，预计卢女士将继续在各种公开活动中亮相，为公众提供更多了解她贡献和努力的机会。